This video is all about the mechanics behind the DiGiCo console integration and how to set it up. Any DiGiCo SD or quantum range console can fully integrate any KLANG processor for a streamlined workflow with full control of all mix parameters from the desk surface. KLANG controls on the touchscreens and rotaries give us full access to the binaural panning and more. Azimuth is the horizontal panning, moving signals around our head. Elevation lets us move audio sources above or below our head. And width decides how far the left and right channel of a stereo pair will be apart in our binaural soundscape. The most frequently used parameters in any mix are, of course, the levels. And we have all of them on the console surface right under our fingertips. The KLANG-activated aux sends, or KLANG nodes, control the level of the corresponding KLANG channel. Turning this KLANG send off or on will mute or unmute the channel in the selected mix. And the solo button in the KLANG controls activates a destructive solo for this input and mix. Since all KLANG levels, mutes, solos, and positions are treated as internal parameters by our console, they are automatically stored and recalled with the internal sends. That means, instead of using a snapshot synchronization as known from some external plugin systems, with KLANG we have 100% access to the DiGiCo snapshot management system, including recall saves, relative changes, auto updates, and more. Firing a snapshot on the console will behave exactly in the same way for the internal stereo auxes as for the KLANG nodes. This also enables us to create useful macros with any KLANG parameters. Bottom line, you are mixing on your console's surface while spoiling your musicians with an immersive in-ear mix. Let's take a look at the necessary steps to set this up. There are two parts: audio routing and control configuration. On the audio side, it depends on your choice of KLANG processor and available audio standards, like using a DMI KLANG built into the console, or MADI, Dante, as well as OptoCore on the external processors. The control side will require the console, processor, and computer running KLANG app to communicate via network. That's why we connect the console's network port to a control port of our KLANG processor and the computer to the other one. With that done, we need to make sure that the IP ranges match so all three devices can actually talk to each other. Generally, we advise to keep the console's IP as it is and adjust addresses on KLANG and computer to match. DiGiCo consoles are set to 192.168 with a 255.255.0.0 subnet mask by default. This means that the consoles are able to communicate with similarly configured devices whose IP addresses also begin with 192.168 and with the same exact subnet mask. For example, if our console is set to 192.168.1.200 with a 255.255.0.0 subnet mask, we can use 192.168.1.100 for our computer and 192.168.1.101 for our KLANG processor. Remember, with a subnet mask at 255.255.0.0, we only need to make sure that the IP address's first two numbers match. The other two may be different. This configuration represents a simple and easy to reproduce setup. There may be situations where we need to consider third-party devices on the same network. In such a case, a more complex configuration may be beneficial, like using two network adapters on the computer with separate IP ranges for the console and KLANG side. For more information on that, please follow this QR code. Another thing to keep in mind is that SD12, as well as all quantum consoles, will use a second IP address for the internal audio engine, one number above the control computer. So make sure to keep this one free. Let's take care of the audio routing next. We have input channel 1 on the left, which we want to use for immersive mixes with KLANG. A tab on the lower part of the channel strip will give us the option to patch the direct out to our KLANG processor's channel 1. The immersive KLANG mix has to be returned back to the console, in this case, into the merge input of our first aux. Once we have activated the KLANG node on channel 1, aux 1, the signal will not pass internally to the aux master anymore, but instead through our KLANG processor. Channel 2 has not been KLANG activated, so this one will hit the console's aux master directly. That means we can choose for each aux send if we want to keep it in stereo or make it immersive. Both will be mixed down together in our aux master, which remains our point to cue and to distribute audio to the musician's ears. Let's set up a DiGiCo and KLANG system together. I'm using an SD11i with a KLANG conductor in this example, but the same exact process applies to any SD or quantum range console with any KLANG processor. The example session on my console has 32 inputs across 23 channels, and I want to use 8 stereo IEM mixes. The channels and auxes are labeled and have some processing applied, but there's no KLANG integration configured. Quick note. In case you are integrating KLANG into an old session, which has seen many changes and additions over the years, it might make sense to restructure the order of channels before you begin with the KLANG integration. This is not necessary, but it might speed up the process significantly. If you're not sure on how to do this, please follow this QR code to Molly's tutorial. KLANG Conductor has been reset by loading the default off KLANG Show, which is a great starting point for setting up the integrated workflow. Audio is going through OptoCore, which is connected but not routed. Network connections between all devices have been plugged in and have been configured as shown previously. Let's begin by routing direct outs from all used channels to KLANG Conductor. For this, we navigate to Layout and open the channel list. And then we activate the Edit function and tap on the output patch for our first channel. Continuing to ripple route 23 channels, beginning with conductor channel 1. A tab on the top of our first aux mix shows the merge input, which gives us the option to select KLANG conductor, return 1 and 2. Since we want to use 8 immersive auxes, we can ripple route again. Don't forget to turn on the merge inputs, as they are deactivated by default. With audio routed, we can now take care of the control configuration. For this, we navigate to Setup and External Control on our console, as well as Config and External Control on KLANG App in Admin mode. We activate External Control, suppress OSC retransmit, the KLANG interface, and optionally link aux to KLANG levels. Now we can add a KLANG device, for which we use our computer's IP address, which is conveniently shown in KLANG App as App IP, and enable. The lower part of this window also reminds us of the console IP address. We're going to need this in the next step. Moving over to KLANG App, where we now enter the IP address of our console. Console type should be DiGiCo SD or SDQ. The init master will let us decide if KLANG or the console will have the last word in case of conflicting mix parameters or after a loss and re-establishment of connection. For setup, we choose console. Three operational modes are offered: off, setup, and active. Setup will make the devices talk and get to know each other without actively changing any levels, positions, mutes, or solos. Once we enter setup mode, KLANG will request information from DiGiCo, like console type, session name, and auxes. The latter show us a not available comment, notifying us that we have not connected them with any KLANG mixes yet. Connect and remote aux takes care of that, aux by aux, or all at once using the ripple function. Once connected, KLANG will automatically pull the aux names from the SC11. Now we can assign input channels in a very similar way. We navigate to the Channels tab and open the Remote Channel drop-down menu, which shows us all input channels in our DiGiCo session. We begin by assigning the first channel, Kick, to the first KLANG channel, which corresponds to the console's direct out patch. This can either be continued on a channel-by-channel basis, or we use the ripple function again. Pay attention to red link icons. They are notifying us that, in this case, the drum overhead channel is set to stereo in the SD11 session, but mono in KLANG. So we should stereo link this channel to the next. Since this makes our mapping skip remote channel 10, we can simply ripple assign from anywhere above the overheads to set it straight. Whenever there are multiple stereo channels in a row, we can simply link them in one go. Again, ripple down from anywhere above this channel. One more time, and we're good to go. No further link warnings. Keep in mind, what we see as remote channel in KLANG app is equivalent to the DiGiCo channel number in the channel list. The KLANG input channel is the actual audio input patched into the KLANG processor and corresponds to the direct out patch from our console. Consider this an easy method to keep an overview, especially in more complex patches. With audio and control set up, we can activate the console link. KLANG app is now asking the console for any active KLANG nodes and their levels, mutes, solos, and positions. Since our session has no active KLANG nodes yet, our channels remain deactivated. Notice the console link indicator. A solid green tells us that all devices are communicating and are set up correctly. It's time to activate KLANG nodes. We begin in our first channel and open the aux panel. Hitting the KLANG activation button allows us to activate KLANG nodes simply by tapping on the aux send. A quick look to KLANG app's fader view confirms that the kick is indeed properly klanged. We could repeat this process manually for every send. Alternatively, we can use the option all function to activate KLANG nodes for an entire layer. Or we simply copy the aux settings, which include KLANG activations and parameters, from the first channel across all following 22 channels. This has activated KLANG in all 8 mixes, and we are ready to adjust levels as well as positions. By the way, you can use the quick positions in KLANG app to find a great starting point for your immersive mixes, because all communication between KLANG and the console is bidirectional. Happy immersive mixing, and stay tuned for part 2 of this video with advanced immersive in-ear mixing functions in DiGiCo SD and Quantum consoles. As always, please do get in touch in case of any questions. We're always looking forward to hearing from you.